Listen, Chandra, the fact is all of us have a story. I have a personal story of the Jaipur Delhi highway, which has been recorded, you know, while I was coming back from an election or a political assignment, where I saw the worst accident of my life. Somebody who I have grown up with just about 10 days ago lost his life at the age of 45. You know, most of us have a story to tell where the national highways are concerned. Why is it, you know, you've been the chairperson of the NHAI. You know, every day we are seeing, witnessing ministers launch new highways. What about the old ones? The apathy continues to kill, sir.
Yes, what you are saying is quite right. It is clearly inexplicable and cannot be justified not taking care of an existing highway stretch, and that also a national highway as important as the Delhi-Jaipur one. That having been said, this has to be tackled at various levels. And the first and immediate task before the National Highway Authority, and I'm sure they are trying to address it, why they have not been able to orchestrate it is beyond my comprehension, because it's an essentially very efficient organization. They should at least do up the potholes immediately. And this is something which can be done across 48 or 56 hours. And there is a standard operating procedure for filling up such potholes to ensure that the damage done is absolutely minimized. Having done that, that is something that needs to be done on a war footing. They should address retopping and relaying the road as fast as they can by appointing a contractor. There are contractors aplenty. If one single contractor is not there, they could perhaps divide it into several parts. So that's, this stretch of 44 kilometers is immediately taken care of. And the third, of course, is what is already being done and which is already on the anvil, is to create greenfield expressways so that, you do not have to go through the cities and the towns where there is, because of which there is very heavy congestion. So you have to tackle it on all three fronts. The third is already being taken care of by building the newly aligned greenfield Delhi to Mumbai expressway, which will go along a different route,
right,
and which will ensure that this is taken.
But Mr. Chandra, as I want to bring in Mr. Pushpeshtra, and I want to ask you, we talk about the greenfield expressway, we talk about the industrial corridor which will be made for trucks from, say, Neem Rana to Behror. The fact is, one can keep talking about launching these new initiatives, new highways, industrial corridors, but one does nothing to what we already have. This is the busiest highway, sir, and you know that better than I in India.
Yes, Preeti, before starting anything, I'll just want to say one thing about the phenomena of the NHAI. NHAI is working on the basis of the concessionaires, and the second chain is the contractors. And it is managed by NHAI, like managers are there, project directors are there. But what happens, hardly they have any visit. They are just working by sitting in the offices. Even I am working on Hero Honda Chowk and Rajiv Chowk. That's a start from the Gurgaon on this highway. These both are the black spots, and they are removing these black spots for last so many years. And still these are the black spots. Main problem is this: on the entire stretch, this drainage system is completely failed. Number two, entry and exit on this highway, this particular highway, is completely ignored as per the national highway laws. Whenever there is a cut, whenever there is an exit, and whenever there is an entry, these are 100% wrong on this highway. And nobody is set accountable, I think. As in Motor Vehicle Act, there is a provision. If something is wrong on the highway and there is a death, then the contractor will be fined for that. No, not the contractor. Project director must be fined for that. What type of management they are doing, what type of visit they are doing, what type of supervision they are doing. Managers are there, project directors are there. They must be set accountable for everything, for the regular supervision. What are they doing in sitting their offices only?